We all wear masks, metaphorically speaking.
It's the single most infamous line of the 1994 hit movie, The Mask. The Masked Magician, The Masked Saint, The Masked Rider. Masks have captured our imagination over the years. From Lucha Libre, which inspired Peter Parker to don a mask as Spider-Man, to Olympic fencers, masked superstars often provoke drama and excitement. Today, we look at the Masked Motivator, first appearing in The Journey, The Making Of, Your Leads Are Now Diamonds. This mystery mascot caught the eye of That's a Good Idea fans all over the world. Now he has become an important part of their brand, and as That's a Good Idea turned their attention to the next album, the Masked Motivator is seeing more and more airtime. Clearly helping to keep the band on track, both as a coach and a role model, the Masked Motivator will likely shape the upcoming music and videos of That's a Good Idea. Where is he from? What motivates the motivator himself? And most importantly, what the world has been asking. Who is under that mask? These are the top 10 secret identities of the Masked Motivator. Number 10 on our list is Mike P. Now hear us out. We know how ridiculous this is, but the conspiracy theory communities of the internet claim that Mike P, guitarist and bassist in That's a Good Idea, and the Masked Motivator are rarely, if ever, seen together. When they are, many claim it is CGI or green screen enhanced. Some say that Mike P and the Masked Motivator are alter egos of the same person. The problem with this theory is that Mike P is a slender guy, and the Masked Motivator is a chiseled, Adonis-like specimen. Coming in, number 9 is Mil Mascaris, and undoubtedly the mask worn by the Masked Motivator is certainly similar to Mil's iconic lucha headgear. Our inspirational mystery man even looks a lot like this pro wrestling Hall of Famer. Unfortunately, Mil doesn't speak much English, and so this choice is also unlikely. Coming in, number 8 is Coach Wooden. We are now moving into the more likely candidates. This high school coach spent a lot of time in some relationship with Ginger and Mike before they decided to form That's a Good Idea. The Masked Motivator certainly has many qualities of a PE teacher from the South. The only thing that makes us think that it couldn't be the coach is the raspy voice of the Masked Motivator compared to the Southern, King of the Hill style voice of Coach Wooden. Still, it's possible that his voice has been edited out. Number 7 on our list is Hormel Corporation CEO Jeff Ettinger. The least recognizable name on this list, Mr. Ettinger is in charge of Hormel Corp, which owns Skippy Peanut Butter. He certainly has the funds to support That's a Good Idea, and this would explain Ginger's fascination with peanut butter. The most compelling evidence is that we can't find proof of Jeff doing anything else. In fact, we had to scour the internet for a picture of him because his corporate website and his wiki page have no pictures. Down to number 6, Richard Simmons. An American fitness guru, actor, and comedian. He promotes weight loss programs prominently through his Sweatin' to the Oldies line of aerobics videos, and he's known for his eccentric, flamboyant, and energetic personality. Sounds just like the Masked Motivator. Since we don't know MM's age, this might just be it. Number 5. Gene Simmons. Another Simmons, but with different logic. Websites like Metal Injection and Loudwire.com often ask two people's opinions about everything. Corey Taylor and Gene Simmons. While Corey Taylor already wears a mask in his first gig and has two other bands going, often at the same time That's a Good Idea or working in the call center between tours. Not likely. But Gene Simmons? He has the right attitude and demeanor to be our guy. Number 4. Paul McCartney. The next on our list also plays bass. Already at the center of both one of the biggest conspiracies and mockumentaries of all time, Sir Paul meets a lot of the requirements for being the Masked Motivator. His British accent is often hidden when singing for Wings, and he has had quite the motivational past. Plus, how cool would it be to hear Sir Masked Motivator? Number 3 is Paul Wall. That's a Good Idea is most known for their rock anthems and guitar heroics, but some of the hidden gems in their musical library are trap beats fused with EDM. Paul Wall is a chopped and screwed guru, so maybe he had some influence from behind that blue and red mask. In 2014, Paul Wall starred in the critically acclaimed theatrical film The Holy Spoof, which sold out in all of its theater showings before its digital stream release online, so he knows a thing or two about all aspects of the That's a Good Idea brand. Number 2. Jeff Probst. After the release of Your Leads Are Now Diamonds, Mike P started visiting exotic locations all over the world. Perhaps this was prompted by the Masked Motivator, and if so, who better to send him on these trips than the host of American reality show, Survivor? Probst has been known to motivate the survivors through encouragement and thoughtful interrogation during tribal councils. He's a little on the short side, but maybe Jeff is wearing lifts. And finally, number one, Samuel L. Jackson. Like Clark Kent entering a telephone booth and coming out as Superman, we don't understand why people don't just admit that the most obvious answer is usually right. What is more motivating than snakes on a plane? We think Samuel L. is our guy. Sound off in the comments below. Who do you think the Masked Motivator is? Subscribe to see all of the cameos our mystery man has made and will make.